Hi, it's Mrs. Michael. So yesterday seemed to be the perfect situation for a launch, right? It was clear blue skies, there were no wind, we had the right balloon. Everything seemed to be fantastic. So I don't know about you, but I was really excited when I was driving home so I could track it. So I was watching it, and I started to see something. All of a sudden, I wasn't getting any more pings. I wasn't getting any more packets of information. Well, that's weird. And I looked at the clock and it was only about lunchtime, so the sun hadn't gone down. Huh. So, like any good scientist, I went to data. So let me show you what I saw and then let's talk about it. So the first thing that I did was I went onto the APRS.fi website and typed in my call sign, KM6BWB, and the number of this tracker was 2. There's my tracker. Uh-oh, the altitude does not look good at 6,600 feet. Let me see if I can figure out a pattern. So I went to try to see the last couple packets of information before that. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more so I can get it. The packet before was at 9,600 feet, so that's a little bit higher. Packet before that was at 11,000 feet, so that's a little bit higher than that. Packet before that was at 12,500 feet, so the balloon was definitely going down. So if I click on info, has a lot of information. Most of it we don't need right now, but we can go to show graphs. Here it has, again, a lot of information that we don't necessarily need, but let's scroll down a little bit. This third graph shows the speed of our transmitter. You can see that it was going up, 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 and then it sort of stabilized for a little bit, and then it had a huge spike when it went really fast. The graph below it is the altitude, how high it was. You can see it was climbing, 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 and then it dropped really, really fast. So if we look at the speed and we look at the altitude, looks like they're hitting the same spot at the same time. Something must have happened.
So we'll never know for sure what really happened. One thing that companies like SpaceX and Northrop Grumman can do when they have issues is they normally have cameras all over so that they can go back and review the footage. We can't do that, so we have to go onto data and make our hypotheses. We have to make our guesses as to what happened. But it looks like, for whatever reason, the balloon burst because it was going up super high, then all of a sudden it turned around and went straight down super fast. Now, we don't know if it's a problem with the balloon, because that can happen. Sometimes there's just a problem with the balloon. We don't know if we put too much gas in it, and so it didn't hit neutral buoyancy like we were talking about. So the air pressure inside got too much and it busted out on the outside. We don't know if it was weather, if there was a bad weather cell that it got into, which it could be. We'll never know for sure. Am I disappointed? Totally. Am I kind of bummed out? Yeah. Am I going to give up? No. I've been doing ballooning for 3 or 4 years, and I have never had back-to-back issues like this. So I think we're just sort of in a sort of bummer streak, but that happens. We definitely are learning after every single launch. And this is even more exciting, is that when we do our next launch, if it goes all the way around the world, it's going to feel even better. So the next launch that we're going to do is really exciting. We're going to be doing it on March 19th. Technically, we're going to be doing it on March 20th, but doing it on March 19th. Because March 20th is the spring equinox. It's when the entire planet changes into the next season. So for the North Hemisphere, it's going to change from winter into spring. And for the Southern Hemisphere, it's going to change from summer into fall. So what some of my ballooning friends and I are going to do is we're going to do an international simultaneous balloon launch at the moment of equinox. So it's super exciting. We're getting everything prepared. We have people from around the world that are getting ready to launch their balloons because we're going to launch them at the exact same time so we can track them all the way around the world. The tough thing is that in Los Angeles, The moment of the spring equinox is at 2:37 a.m. So that's the middle of the night when everybody's sleeping. So my ballooning partner and I are probably going to stay up all night so that we can launch our balloon at 2:37 a.m., even though we won't be able to see it, because that's when everybody else around the world is launching at that time in their time zone. So for some people, it might be launching at 5:37 in the morning. It might be launching at 1:37 in the afternoon, just depending on where they are around the world. So that's our next launch. If you've got any ideas, feel free to email me. I hope you guys had fun tracking it, even though it wasn't a very long adventure this time. Start coming up with ideas. Maybe if you have a different hypothesis as to what happened with our balloon, let me know. You never know. Have a great day, Wiseburn. Hi, it's Mrs. Michael. So yesterday seemed to be the perfect situation for a launch, right? It was clear blue skies, there were no wind, we had the right balloon. Everything seemed to be fantastic. So I don't know about you, but I was really excited when I was driving home so I could track it. So I was watching it. And I started to see something. All of a sudden, I wasn't getting any more pings. I wasn't getting any more packets of information. Well, that's weird. And I looked at the clock, and it was only about lunchtime, so the sun hadn't gone down. Huh. So, like any good scientist, I went to data. So let me show you what I saw, and then let's talk about it.